Hi, my name is Terrestrial. I am an Animal Crossing and Sim streamer over on Twitch, and also DIY lover. I feel like when you first start streaming, there's a lot of pressure to start like commissioning emotes, commissioning people to make your overlays, do all this stuff and spend a lot of money. There are definitely ways to get around having to do that, having to find people, pay people, come up with all these ideas and stuff, and one of those ways is through Canva. And if you don't know what Canva is, it is literally the best thing on the internet. I promise you, please go look it up, like literally right now, canva.com. In today's video, we're gonna be going over how to make your own overlays and scenes. We'll get to the emotes and stuff in a different video, but today it's gonna be about BRB, starting soon, ending soon, whatever else scene you need, I don't really know. But we're gonna show you how to make it animated, we're gonna show you how to make it cute and clean, and let your imagination go wild. So let's get to it. So when you first get to Canva, you'll see that you can literally do anything. This is how I do all of my overlays, all of my social media posts, literally anything you could possibly want. But today, again, we're gonna focus on the overlays. So first things first, you need to figure out what size overlay you need to even create. For me, I like to stream in 1080, so I am gonna do 1920 by a 1080 pixel canvas. For you, you might stream in 720, so you need to go figure that out. Usually you can see that in Streamlabs or OBS or whatever the heck software you use to stream from, and then we can get started. So like I said, for me, I stream in 1080, so I'm just gonna go here, and it's already done for me because I use this all the time. You click it, and then you have your blank canvas where you can literally do anything, and this is where you should let your imagination go absolutely wild. Personally for me, I used a video as the background for all of my scenes and overlays, and I just use the same video over and over again to keep everything consistent, and it's basically just looped in Streamlabs, so once it runs out, it just loops back around and then it's just an endless animation. There are stickers in Canva, which are little animated graphics. These are great, but I think if you wanted a full background of animation, definitely videos is the way to go. These are just a few examples. There's all kinds of stickers. There's not just like this, I don't know, is that tape? I think it's tape or something. But there's all kinds of things that you can use. Again though, it's all up to preference. I'm going to be showing you how to make overlays with video backgrounds. So going back to videos, which you can find in the left-hand corner, you'll see that some of them say free and some of them say pro. Now, personally, I have Canva Pro because I want access to all the things. Give me all the things. but you can totally do this with the free tier as well. It just takes a little more time to kind of sort through and see what's free and what is with the paid membership. So you also have to think about branding too. So I went through and I literally just typed in purple because I really love purple and that is a huge part of my brand. And I tried out these are all the ones that I tried out. So many different videos. It's just endless. So you'll have to do the same. You got to think about what colors go with your brand. If there's a certain thing that goes with your brand too, you can also type in like, I don't know, if your thing is cats, like cat, and there's cat videos too if you want that. I don't know. Do whatever you want to do. But for me, it was purple and I wanted something kind of interesting, so I chose this one. So then from here, it's super simple. You just click it, it puts it right onto your canvas, expand it out to the corners, and you have your animated background. Look at that thing go. So animated. For me, I thought this was really cool. It was very on brand, and I thought that it would really kind of calm my viewers when they first came in to the stream, especially for the starting soon and the BRBs. I wanted them to feel like chill and like happy and all the bright colors and stuff. So think about that kind of stuff too while you're picking out a video, because this is the background for your brand. And now it's really quite simple. I basically just put text, which is right here in the left-hand side, over this video. Again, think about branding when you're picking out your text. For me, I really wanted something kind of cursive-y and cute, because that's another thing that we really think about on my channel. You can change the font size. I'll probably do like, I don't know, 150. So then I did something a little different just to make it really stand out from the background. I really love this effect called neon. So the effects are up here. They're different text effects you can do. There's different styles and shadows and lifts and whatever else you want to do. For me, I pretty heavily rely on this neon one. It just kind of makes it look like it's glowing and it's really cute. And you can also change the color here. And I typically go for gold. So this stands out, right? But it's still kind of blurry. It's not very, you know, clean lines or anything, and it can look better. So what I do is I usually duplicate and then drag it over. Then I get rid of the neon effect. And then I change the text color to white. So now it really stands out. There's like that subtle glow around it and it looks real cute. And then that's literally all you have to do to have a completed starting soon, BRB, whatever scene. Just change the text to BRB, ending now, whatever you need. And everything's cohesive and branded and it looks so cute. So let's see this all together. Now, obviously the branding is gonna be different. You're gonna have your own videos and fonts and all the things. So it's gonna take you time to figure out what that's going to look like. But once you do, it's so easy and so straightforward. So we've got your scenes all figured out. Let's see what your overlay is gonna look like. Now, personally for me, I have a very basic overlay. I have literally just this top bar and then me in the corner in front of a green screen. So it's very simple, very clean, but still cute and adds to the branding. And it's not just like in your face. So for me, I'm gonna show you how to make just a really simple top bar. So this is the one that I currently have. I'm about to delete everything and show you how I did it. And just so you know, the dimensions that I used is 1920 by 80 pixels. And honestly, this could probably be even just a hair thinner as well. You could totally get away with 75 or 70 pixels, but I wouldn't go much smaller than that because you still want the stuff to be like readable at the top of your scene. Okay, so let's go ahead and delete everything. Just get rid of it all. Oh. And let's go find the video that we used previously for the overlays. Now again, you can do whatever the heck you want to do. I just really love to keep everything cohesive and the same thing and kind of deal because branding is just so important. So I'm going to pick a part that's kind of interesting, but doesn't have too much going on with the video. I think when I did this originally, I did something like this part. So you at least had some birds and stuff and like some little hearts and things flowing by. But we can go check it out right now. Yeah, this is definitely not too busy and you'll still be able to see the animations and stuff, but it's not going to take your eye away from the font and stuff. Okay, so let's go back. And first things first, I'm going to go ahead and add my username to the very middle. Again, you gotta get that branding in. So I'm gonna go to text and then I'm going to use the same font that I use for all of my overlays and scenes, do the same kind of thing with the neon effect, and then overlay it with like a white font with nothing going on with it so that it pops off of the scene. And there you go, there's your branding. Looks cute, it's readable, it could be a little bigger, but you know, it's whatever. That's something you'll have to play around with. So now it's time to showcase your latest follower, subscriber, cheerer, donator, whatever. And we need to do that with tabs. Now for me, I just use this oval looking shape and then overlaid two of them so that one was a lighter pink and then the bottom one was a darker pink just to add a little more pizzazz or whatever. And where you go to find that is if you go to elements. I just literally typed an oval and then looked for an eternity to find this particular one. I know there's so many, but I'm just very picky. But this is the one that I landed on. You can change the color, which is really nice, and I like that a lot. And also, it fits just so nicely with the width of this top bar. So let's make this one this big and then kind of put it here. We'll kind of mess with this and make it fit eventually. I also want to change the color, and you want to make sure that your colors are really spot on to whatever background you're using and that they don't clash. So I went ahead and kind of chose colors that really represented these colors in the background. I think I'm gonna make this maybe like, honestly, we could go for this purple, looks nice. And I think it stands out pretty well. So we'll go with this purple, duplicate, make it a little bit smaller so that it fits inside this oval. And then we're gonna change the color to something lighter so that you can actually read the text. Now, I'm not crazy about this color combo. Maybe we'll change this to actually like a light pink. So now you have your little tabs for your stream labels for all of your latest followers, subscriber, whatevers. And it's super easy. Again, you can let your imagination go wild. Everybody's got different tastes and preferences. Take some time to really look through and see what's available. And you never know what you're going to find. So now you need something to represent each thing. Again, we're gonna go be in elements, which is where pretty much all of the clip art type stuff is in Canva. I think for followers, I literally just typed in person, maybe? Something more solid like this would be the best route to go so that it stands out. So I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger. We're gonna drag it on top of this little label. And there you go. You have your follower label now. And now the key is just picking a color that's gonna stand out against the rest, but also still go. I think I did blue on my current one, and it doesn't stand out a ton on that blue. Maybe we could find something else. Maybe this lighter blue. This will be fine for the purpose of just showing you how to do this, but it's just really easy. So you take the same kind of idea and apply it for subscribers, for donators, for cheerers. So here we're back at the header that I'm currently using. I think the only one that I kind of had to make myself was this donation tab. It's literally just a heart with a dollar sign on it. So the great thing about Canva is if there's something that doesn't quite suit what you want, you can literally just paste it together and it looks really good. And that's another reason that I really love Canva. And most of the stuff that I use is on the free tier. The only thing that I used that I show you that is not on the free tier is this video. But again, there's plenty of videos that will suit your brand that are on the free tier if you don't want to pay for Canva Pro. So let's say you want an overlay while you're playing your game or whatever you're doing. That has a background and it's kind of sectioned off like this. Now, personally for me, this is my just chatting scene. I don't have one of those overlays that takes up the whole thing. I pretty much let the game be the whole background on my streams, but I know everybody has different tastes. But this is so easy and it's the same kind of idea as the starting soon and BRB scenes and stuff. It's literally just the video in the background, and then I have this box to section off where the game's gonna go, and then here is a box for chat. Now, you can do this however you want. You could make this into a face cam box by literally just making it smaller and then overlaying your face cam when you put this into Streamlabs or wherever you're using OBS, whatever. These are literally just an element of an Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok graphics. They're just elements. If you go back to elements, if you type in TikTok, all kinds of stuff comes up. You literally have your pick as to what graphic to choose. And then if you press this little button right here in the top right, you can press see more like this, and this will show you others in the grouping. So like they'll all go. So here, if you like this TikTok look, let's say you want to show off Snapchat, they have a Snapchat element to go with it. So it all looks cohesive and the same. But really, when it comes to this, it is just all about creativity and letting your creativity go wild. Like I said, the main things that if you want an animated background is choose a video and then kind of block off where you want things. So I would say this would be where your game would go. Your face cam would probably go here, and maybe you might have a small box right here for chat to go into. But it's really all up to you, and it's just so easy if you have an idea of what you want. I really hope you found this tutorial useful. Tell me all about your overlays in the comments when you make them. I'm gonna wanna hear about it. And let me know if you have any questions too. I'm always down to help. Also, if you find out that all the stuff that you wanna use is on Canva Pro, you can use my affiliate link, which I've put down in the description, to get Canva Pro for free for 30 days. So you can try it out totally for free. See if you like it. And if you do, continue. That's fantastic. And if you don't, you can go back to the free tier. It's all good. But if you do want to try Canva Pro, use my affiliate link. It's down in the description. And it's just so easy to sign up. Thank you so much for watching. I super appreciate it. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And I will see you next time.